In this lesson, we will create the nanotech effect, not exactly like Infinity War, but you can use this technique to create that. I just want it for the glove, so it's a much cheaper version of the actual nanotech effect. If you guys like my videos and want to support me, please hit the like button. There are some really good plugins available to pull this off, but we won't use any. During job interviews, you can't rely on plugins. The studio may not have them. Okay, let's begin. I will hide everything we don't need. Once the repulsor lands, the glove will start forming. This is the worst model I've ever made. You guys do better, okay? Don't disappoint Tony like I did. These polygons are too small. I'll reduce turbo smooth iterations. Just like in real life, size matters, guys. Each polygon will be turned into this small box, so better topology will give us better result. Secondly, we don't want the model to have any thickness. Now that's a sentence I thought I would never have to say. We want different texture on the inside, so later we will add thickness using the shell modifier. Okay, to remove the inner side, let's add another edit poly on top. Now select all the polygon loops which are connecting the outside of the model to the inside. To select a polygon loop, first select a polygon, then hold shift and select the polygon next to it. Now hold control and select all the polygon loops that are connecting both sides. Okay, hit delete. Now both layers are disconnected, which means now they are separate elements. So choose element or press 5 on your keyboard, select the inner element and hit delete. Now this doesn't have any thickness. I'll hide the base model. Yet again the polygons are too small. Let's remove all the extra edges. Choose edge. Double click on edge to select edge loop. Hold control and select all the edge loops which need to be removed. Now hit backspace to remove edges. There's a difference between removing and deleting edges. This is removing. And this is deleting. Let's remove this one also. Hit backspace. Okay, now the polygon sizes are kind of even. Next step will be to disconnect each polygon from one another. Right now these polygons are connected, which makes them one big element. I want each polygon to be a separate element. For that, choose edges. Select all the edges and click on this split button. It's found in the edit edges panel. Now choose element and you can see they are not connected anymore. Now the model is not smooth anymore. It has hard edges. We will fix that later. Okay, now make a copy. Yes, we are again going to use the morpher. I have explained morpher thoroughly in the third lesson, so if you guys don't understand anything, then go and watch third lesson again. Or let me know in the comment section. Back to the original one. Select all the elements. Press R to activate scale and scale down all the elements to 0. Make them invisible. Next, as usual, apply morpher and select this one as target. Now if you change this value, you get this type of effect. There's a small trick you can use with morpher. Go to the edit poly which is below the morpher and select a few vertices. Now go back, keep the selection as it is, and if you change this value, you can see the effect is only applied on the selected vertices. So what you can do is use soft selection. Reduce the falloff value. And you get this type of effect. This is good, but we have one more trick up our sleeve. Let's not select vertices like this. For that, let's use a modifier called volume select. In this, set the selection level to vertex. Now any vertex that comes inside this box will be automatically selected. So if I move this box, select gizmo over here to move it. You can see the vertices outside the box get deselected. And even this one has soft selection. Now we can simply animate the box. Here instead of box, we can use sphere, cylinder or any other object. So let's do that. I'll make a sphere. Align it here. Make it smaller. Now animate this thing. Turn on auto key. Set a keyframe from where you want it to start animating. Go ahead, scale up and cover the entire object. Okay, turn off auto key and I'll drop its visibility. Now add the sphere in volume select. Click on this none and select the sphere. Okay, let's see. Wait. Oh yeah, I forgot to turn on animate in the edit poly. Now it's working. Wait. Increase the polygon count. Still it's getting stuck. Let me move this. Okay. Just a glitch. Probably won't happen in your computer. This is pretty good for the effect we are after. But we have one more sleeve with one more trick or technique, whatever. Delete the sphere. Turn off volume select. Turn off auto key. This time we will use splines instead of objects to select the vertices. Select edit poly so that you will get all these options. If this shelf is missing, right click in this area and turn on ribbon. Then you may have to click on this button to maximize and select edit poly to get these options. Here go to freeform. We will use freeform to draw splines on the object. Okay, here instead of grid, select surface and pick the object you want to draw upon. Check the object name over here. Wait, let me just throw this with other morph targets. Okay, select edit poly again, select splines and simply draw. We will connect this later. Let's make a few more. We will use this technique to give proper direction to the nanoparts. Turn off edges so you can see properly. You can even use this technique to draw veins or something. To connect two splines, simply select two vertices and click on this weld button. If both the vertices are far from each other, then increase distance value over here and again hit weld. Here we have multiple splines inside spline. Both are called the same. Let's call this one spline object. Some people call them shapes. Okay, so I showed you how to connect splines that are inside one spline object. In case you made two different spline objects, then select one of them. Click on attach button to activate it. Then select the spline you want to attach. Now this is one spline object. So now again you can select two vertices and weld them. If you want to connect them through a line, then turn on connect over here. Go on a vertex, left click and hold it. Go to the next vertex and release left click. Let me connect the broken splines. Okay, now I'll remove all the extra vertices. It's not necessary if you have a fast computer. You can see we have one yellow vertex on each spline. That's the first vertex. So if you assign an object to animate on that spline, it will always begin animation from the first vertex. When you attach two splines, the first vertex may change. So to set first vertex, simply select the vertex and click on this make first button. Next step, make a cylinder. Let me turn on display edges. We will make this cylinder travel on the splines. So increase the height segments so that it bends properly on the spline. And I'll reduce the sides just to decrease the polygon count. Okay, I'm gonna detach all splines into different spline objects or shapes. Okay, now select cylinder. I'm gonna use a modifier called part deform WSM. Make sure to use the WSM one. The other one is useless. Don't use that. In this, click on pick path and select the spline. Then your object will be gone somewhere. Like that. Click on move to path to bring it in place. Now if I increase the stretch value, it will travel on the path. Let's edit the cylinder. Turn this off. I'll add taper and set the amount to -1. Now turn on path deform, you get this type of effect. It's thin at start and feels like it's growing over time. I'll turn off taper for now. Okay, change the stretch value to 0. You can see our object is still there. So if I add this in volume select, this much part will stay visible. Let's see how it goes. Okay, not bad. But we don't want this to be visible at start. So to fix that, you can either animate the soft selection value, or you can just move the first vertex away from the model. This fix is way better. Same goes for all the splines. So now there's nothing at start. Now let's place cylinders on each path. Press Ctrl plus V to make copy. Here I'll select instance so that any changes we make in the cylinder will be applied to all the copies. In this, pick a different path. Okay, repeat the steps. So this repulsor land on frame 50, then this thing is closed. So we'll start cylinder animation from somewhere around here. Okay, set the stretch value to 0, then I'll go to frame 70 and we will finish animation over here. Turn on auto key and increase the stretch value. Let's try 30. We only need it till here. So 24 is good. Now I'll bring the first frame forward, so that the glove appears right after these two things close. Okay, now let's repeat the animation on all cylinders. Now to make all the cylinders work, we will have to add more volume select modifiers. So let's add volume select. Make sure it's below the morpher. Selection level to vertex, and in mesh object, add another cylinder. Now only this one is visible, cause it's on top. So in selection method, instead of replace, select add. So this cylinder selection will be added with the previous selection. Don't change the bottom volume select, keep it on replace only. Okay, let's see. The fall off value is 0.4 on this one, so I'll keep it same on the new volume select. Now let's copy paste the modifier, so that we won't have to type the values again. You can also hold shift and drag the modifier to make a copy. Oh no, I forgot to turn off the auto key. I don't want to animate the fall off. Okay, again I'll make a copy. And here just change the mesh object. Repeat this step until you get all the cylinders. So this is what we have till now. Once the cylinders are about to reach, I'll increase their scale. So it looks like the particles are spreading. From 65 we can start scaling till here. Okay. Turn on auto key and increase the radius. Keep increasing until all the polygons are scaled properly. Bring this key forward. Here you can see the radius animation got applied on all cylinders, even though we did it only on one of them. That's because we selected instance when we made all these copies. Okay, now let's hide the cylinders. Whoa. This is some kind of glitch. We don't want to render the cylinders, so right click, object properties, and uncheck on renderable. Hold on, let me reduce its visibility too. Never mind, let's just hide them. Now we get this. It would have looked better with smaller polygons, but they won't be properly visible from this distance. That's why I kept them bigger. Okay, I'll keep the cylinders and splines hidden in a different layer. Now let's add thickness. For that I'll use shell modifier. Wow. Keep outer amount to 0 and inner set it something like 0.1. It's still too much. Let's try 0.05. Okay. Check on overhead inner material ID and edge material ID. In our model, this is the edge and this is the inner. Now let's change the material. Here we have a multi-sub object. In this you can place multiple materials and give ID to them. We will use those IDs to apply different material on the inner polygons. Here ID1 is red material, and ID2 is the gray metallic one. If you guys don't know how to create materials, don't worry. In the next lesson, we are going to do lighting and texturing from scratch. I'll explain everything you need to know about materials in that lesson. I'll apply this material on the object. And in shell, I'll select inner material ID to 2. Now all the inner polygons have metallic texture. Let's do the same for the edge polygons. Okay, now we have two things to fix. First, these points which appear because of the shell. And second, these hard edges. We want the model to be smooth and not so boxy. To fix this one, add an edit poly on top. Choose vertex and select all the vertices. Now right click and click on the box next to weld. In weld options, adjust the distance. Just enough that these points become invisible and everything else remains. This looks good enough. No. Let's weld again. Increase the distance. So what weld is doing is, it's merging all the vertices whose distance is 0.04 cm or less. They get merged with the closest vertex. Remember, our thickness value in the shell was 0.05 cm. So keep weld distance below that, otherwise there won't be any thickness remaining. Now let's fix the hard edges. Adding smooth or turbo smooth modifier won't work here, cause the polygons are not connected to each other. For this, make another edit poly, which is below the shell. Again, select all the vertices. Let me turn these two off. Again, right click and weld. Here, keep the distance as less as possible, but not zero. So I'll keep 0.001, so that only the vertices that are overlapping each other will get merged. So what we are doing here is, the polygons which we disconnected in the start are again being connected, and this is one whole element again. And you can see everything still works. The placement of edit poly in this modifier list is very critical for this effect to work. We don't have the hard edges anymore. Okay, this looks nice. You can make a bunch of copies of the glove just to add more detail to it. Just give them some variation. I'll make one. Let's add push modifier to make it smaller. Place push below the shell modifier. I'll give a different texture. I'll increase the soft selection value on all volume select. Check this out. Now we got two layers. First the inside one comes out, then the red one follows. You see, so quickly we doubled the detail in this effect. Let's see it in the camera view. Oh yeah. And you can turn on taper to get a different look. Just adjust the taper amount or scale to cover all the polygons. You can even add wireframe material on the smaller glove. Or simply add the lattice modifier. Do whatever you want. Your movie, your rules. If you guys have any doubts, do let me know in the comment section. In the next lesson, we will do lighting, texturing and render the scene. If you found this tutorial helpful, then please hit the like button. Thanks for watching. See you guys in the next one.